Discover Vitroids and Lenticule Discs, certified reference materials containing a precise number of colony-forming units of bacteria, yeast, or fungi. Innovation and precision guaranteed. See how to apply these discs to inoculate agar plates or liquid medium, dilute a suspension, or use in membrane filtration. Each disc comes in a microvial, in which it lies on a white filter plug. At the bottom of the vial, there is desiccant, which should be yellow. If the desiccant has turned white, do not use the disc. The microvials come in a waterproof mylar foil bag, each containing 10 vials. The bags can be stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius. When a disc is needed, open the mylar foil bag stored in the freezer and take out only a single vial. Then, reseal the bag. Let the vial stand for 5 to 10 minutes to reach ambient temperature. Do not refreeze it. Use the disc within 1 hour of transfer to ambient temperature. The discs can be used to directly inoculate solid media. Open the vial and drop the disc onto the agar plate. Close the plate and leave at room temperature for the disc to rehydrate. After 10 to 15 minutes, check that it has fully dissolved, leaving only a drop. Spread the drop over the entire plate. Incubate the plate according to the guideline. Take the plate out of the incubator and count the colonies. If the disc has a higher concentration or is used to inoculate liquid media, the Vitroids and Lenticule discs can directly be rehydrated in liquid medium or buffer to finally dilute the CFU and inoculate an agar plate. Take a vial that has reached ambient temperature. Open it and drop the disc into the buffer or medium to be used. Leave the inoculated liquid at room temperature for 10 to 15 minutes. Apply the right amount of inoculum onto an agar plate for the desired CFUs. Spread the liquid over the entire plate. Incubate the plate according to the guideline. Take the plate out of the incubator and count the colonies. If the discs are used in membrane filtration, they can be rehydrated in sterilized tap water, buffer, or dilution solvent. Never rehydrate in distilled water. Take a vial that has reached ambient temperature. Open it and drop the disc into the buffer, diluent, or sterilized tap water. Shake gently and leave inoculated liquid at room temperature for 10 to 15 minutes. Shake gently again. Filter the liquid through a membrane filter. Once completed, remove the funnel of the filtration unit. Then carefully remove the membrane with a forceps and place it on an agar plate. Incubate the plate according to the guideline. Take the plate out of the incubator and count the colonies. To transfer microorganisms between different U.S. states, you need a permit. Here is how to proceed. Click the following link to access the USDA Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service. Then you have different APHIS e-files to choose from. In our case, you are not in the state of Missouri. We need an interstate transit for bacteria and fungi, which is important for Vitroids and lenticule discs. Follow the link to the application form. Here you can see different registers. choose Organisms and Vectors. Then go to Movement Type and select Interstate Transport. Under Category, choose, for example, Livestock or Poultry Pathogen. Then select an organism. For example, Listeria monocytogens as a live isolate. Under Exposed to, Isolated from, you can choose, for example, ruminant, equine, or porcine. Press Search, and the species will appear below. Click on Add Material to add it to the basket. After choosing all the needed species, press the basket icon, and all selected species will be listed. You will see more details and if a permit is required. In that case, you will see the estimated processing fee. You can then click Proceed to Login to finish your order. For questions, contact our technical service. Visit our website to explore the range of organisms and CFUs available on our Vitroids and Lenticule discs. Find application notes, including guidelines on spiking samples, and download the certificate of analysis.